Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Miss Brooke, the Director of Evangelism here at St. John's Episcopal Church, and I'm so excited to be here with all of you for today's Children's Chapel. Do you remember when we gather together, the very first thing that we do? That's right, we light those candles, and I went ahead and lit them, and later we're going to light another candle, so be on the lookout for that. Now that we do that, we go on to our liturgical calendar and we find where we are. Anyone see? We're going from November 1st to November 8th, and we're still in the really long season after Pentecost, but we're approaching Advent, which is very, very exciting. Now, will you sing with me our gathering song? Come everybody, gather together. Come everybody, gather together. Come everybody, gather together. Come everybody, gather together. Come, let us worship our God. Thank you so much for singing with me. Now, we're going to do our collect. A collect is a special prayer of call and response that we like to do in our faith tradition. So I say, the Lord be with you. Then you say, probably remember by now, and also with you. And then we pray. You fold your hands. Very good. Let us pray. Jesus, we are gathered because you taught us how to be children of God. By your Holy Spirit, nurture us as your people of the resurrection. We say, Amen. Before we tell our story, we want to give praise to God for this day, for the beauty of it, and for all the good things in our lives. And we do that by singing a song of praise called a doxology. You do that with me now? Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him all creatures here below. Praise him above ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Great job. So in our gospel passage, for this week, Jesus tells a parable. Do you remember what a parable is? A parable is like a story that Jesus tells to make a really interesting point. And this story is about waiting for the return of the Lord and about all those that keep their lamps burning brightly, waiting for this moment. Wow, that language is complicated. So let's see if we can break it down so that we can all understand it. Always, but especially in these days, there is so much that remains uncertain in our lives. There are so many things that we don't and that we simply can't know. We don't know what changes will happen in our neighborhood and in our country. We don't know if someone that we love might become sick. And we don't know if something scary might come our way. We also don't know, like in the parable, the day that the Lord will return. Our complete lack of knowledge about the future can make the road ahead of us seem dark, scary, and empty. And so what can we do to fix that? Somehow, we must bring light. Do you know what I love, friends? That a really dark room can find brightness with the lighting of just one candle. And I want to show you that this morning. See how dark it is? We light the match. We simply light one candle. And that one candle makes it so that we can see in the dark. We need to be like that candle and let our lights shine brightly. What does that mean, really? It means that by being kind, by loving others when it's hard to do so, and by offering peace in challenging times, we become a bright light of Jesus and a light for the world. Amen. I'm going to keep this lit as we continue our worship service, because at the end, I want to sing a song that you probably all know with you. So the next thing that I want to do is remember that the best way to be bright lights is to remember who we are and to whom we belong to. That helps us keep these lights burning brightly as children of God. Today, let's say the Children's Creed to remember who we are and whose we are. You can repeat after me. We believe in God above. We believe in Jesus's love. We believe in the Spirit too, that comes to show us what to do. We believe in God's one church. We believe baptism makes us one with each other. We believe God forgives. And we believe in the life in the world to come. Amen. Will you pray with me what we call the prayers of the people? The very first thing that we pray for are all the good and wonderful and beautiful things that are happening in our lives and in our world. We name them either aloud or quietly in our hearts, and then we say, thank you so much, God. God, I thank you for fall. I thank you for new friends and for books to read and for the questions that you help us ask our teachers. We say thank you so much, God. And now we pray for the things that might be concerning or troubling to us, the things that we're not sure about. And as we list them, again, either quietly or aloud, we say afterwards, help us, God. We trust in you. Lord, I pray for those who are alone, those who are sick, and those who have very uncertain and scary futures. We say, help us, God. We trust in you. The very last thing that we pray for are all the things that we're sorry for, the things that we do that aren't always loving to those around us or that don't always show God's love perfectly. We remember, as we list them, that nothing in the whole world can ever separate us from God's love. That's right. We're sorry, God, that sometimes we act in our anger, and sometimes we hurt those that we love and those that are in need. We're sorry, God. Thank you for always loving us. Now, before we go, I thought we would sing a brand new song. That's kind of fun, right? I think so. And the song is, you might know it, This Little Light of Mine, to match our candle. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. All around the neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. All around the neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. All around the neighborhood, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I'm gonna hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Can you try that? Hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel? No, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Don't let Satan it out. Can you try that? Don't let Satan it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan it out. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Very good. Thank you for joining me for Children's Chapel and trying new things. I hope that you're a bright light this week, and I'll see you next week.